If you have the same desire, but you can attempt it towards an expansive and extensive war, then you will be civilized. Then if the same desire is advanced in curiosity with more levels of comprehension of the surroundings, with the persistent and targeted curiosity, that is science. If it is applied in dexterity and performance skill, that is known as technology. So human being survival, second thing is civilization, third thing is science, fourth thing is technology. Everything is an advancement of his desired level of curiosity. And when he is promoted, when he is hyper-promoted, when he is made super-active, when he is made supra-professional in nature, he designs the things out of the nuances, out of the intricacies and complexities of nature, he designs everything. So, you have to start with the desire. And the second thing is the desire, design or desire pattern. If there is a desire, certainly you know that whenever there is a vegetable, whenever something is having life, you should have two things. One is preservability, second is decay. And if something is not preserved, if something is not consumed or utilized, if something is not converted into a palatable, applicable, accommodable and assimilable methodology, certainly it will be subjected to decay, either external decay or internal repulsive decay. Likewise, this desire had inbuilt preservatives. What is that? Honesty, humility, compassion, love towards others, mercy. These are all the reflex responses of human intelligence associated with the desire. If the natural, inhibited, inherent, innate systems of preservatives that have been molded along with this desire mechanism, if it is not there, if it is vanished, if it is debilitated or diluted, then this characteristic decay is unavoidable. Just as material decay is unavoidable for vegetative matter, if the preservability process remains, if a person is not having a preservative for his desire, the desire will result in a characteristic decay. This type of characteristic decay has resulted in two major principles of biomagnetism known as attraction and repulsion. Mismanagement and mismatch of two things, attraction and repulsion. Attraction means liking something, and repulsion is not liking something. These two qualities, just as a small spark or scintillant that becomes a basic effulgent radiant fire if it is not properly nurtured, directed or distilled. These two major fires, they acquire two different shapes, which is told in the Bhagavad Gita as Kama and Krodha. The liking of a person at the pinnacle of the stage, at the pyramidal edge, at the state of unsaturable culture,